Hi everybody, welcome to our new video. Today we're going to show you how to set up your printer. Ricoh, it's a 171 to your laptop. So this laptop doesn't print. We just put in this printer, but it doesn't print. We're trying to print, doesn't print. So what we're going to do, we're going to connect the printer back. Then I'll show you how it works. You get your network cable, your printer cable. It looks like this side, and you connect it there. See there, I guess you see where I connected it. I'm gonna take out this USB. Okay, once you connect, you know that the printer is in power. So, but if you're using Windows 10, you might have a chance that driver is gonna be downloaded by default. So, but on Windows XP, we're finding that Windows 7, we're finding a problem to have the printer work. So now the reason why we installed Windows 7 here, because the machine was slow. So now here, what we do, we can try to restart the computer and see if it's gonna work, because for now it doesn't work. How? So I'm gonna look for Office Word. I'm looking for Microsoft Word. Then I try to get something. Then when I try to print, I'm trying to print here. You remember, a printer to work on any machine, it needs its software, what they say, drivers. That makes the software connect between the two, the machine and the computer. So if we say we want to print, we cannot see here our printer. So there's no communication between the printer and the computer. That's why it can't connect. So we need a drivers. Those are called drivers or softwares, which the software for this printer, which can sit on this computer to tell the computer that there's a machine which wants to do operations. So since now we cannot print, even if we want to print, what can we print? Nothing. So even if you click printing, it won't print. You can see, because there is no printer drivers. So the best thing, sometimes that's why you can see it says before you can use this feather, what you must do, whatever. So leave that. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna restart the computer. Sometimes when you restart the computer, it gets the drivers. So let's try to shut the machine down. I'm shutting the machine down. Okay, the machine is down, so it's off. So I'm gonna switch it on back. And Windows 7 is no more supported by Microsoft. That's one of the challenges you might face. So I switch on the machine back. So when the machine is on, that's when we're gonna start doing things. Yeah, so it's on. It's on now. We're waiting for the desktop to show up. Okay, it shows up. Okay, so let's wait for the icons to be ready. Once this is no more rotating, so you're gonna get to that. Okay, so we're back to here. We're gonna look for Word. We try to print, we see if the drivers were set. Sometimes when you install the machine, you have to restart. You can see Microsoft Office 2010. It okay, then we try to print out. Since we can't print, let's see if we can print this time. Still we can't get a machine. If we scroll down here, we can't get a machine. So what you do is say try to add printer. Okay, it gives us that error. So you can go to here, and look for control panel, devices and printers. Then here, what you're gonna do, you're gonna have to, you see this machine is here. Once you click on it, look what it says. Still, it can show the machine, but it's not, it should have icons like this. So what you do, you're gonna add a printer, click on add printer. Once you click on that, it's gonna say local machine or network. We say local machine. Okay, it say from port whatever. So let's see. USB, what virtual USB. You can leave the way it is, then you go next. So when you go next here, you can go and look for what we're looking for. We're looking for Ricoh. You can see in this section, you look for Ricoh. You can even click somewhere here and you look for R, Ricoh. Yes, we got Ricoh. So here in Ricoh section, you can look for 107171 for your printer model. If it's here, you're gonna be lucky. If it's not here, then we're sorry. I think it's not here. Let's see. 171 is not here. So since it's not here, let's try to take the first one and say next and say next. Okay, in most cases, when you select the first one, it installs, it can work. But if it doesn't, we're gonna see, look into that. I say next, say try to make a printer test page. A test page has been sent to your printer. So if the printer doesn't print, then we're gonna go to the second method. So finish. You can see it should look like this, but this time the printer did not print. So now what we're gonna do, we're gonna look for Word again and try to print out. Do what print? It's a process. Okay. I'm trying to print, but there's nothing coming out of the printer, which is okay. I don't mind about that. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go to the internet and I look for that specific printer drivers. Okay, I clicked on Google, then say Ricoh 171 drivers. Okay, drivers. Okay, you can see this support dot what what, so you can download here. It comes here, it say 171, but that's not, it can go to all these series. It's because this will say 171 17 whatever, so all of that is okay. So when you go here, it can say, it can tell you here that P6 whatever English. So you can see the date was 2015 when they did made these drivers. So you can scroll down. We're looking for, these are mini drivers, XP, okay, XPS. It doesn't ask us Windows. Let's click on Windows. We need Windows, okay. 32-bit, 62. So before we install, we have to see which kind of Windows we're using. You go to My Computer, Computer, then you say Properties. When you go to Properties, you can say we're using Windows 7 Ultimate, but we're using a 64-bit. You can see it's 64-bit, so don't download something which you don't understand. You can download this for 64-bit, 7, Windows 7, 64-bit. You say download. When you click on that, so it's going to give you more options. On those options, you can click, you say printer driver for black and white printer and color printing. In Windows, it will support HP CPCLX whatever command. So we're gonna download these ones. The first one, okay. We click the download. Let's see, it's downloading here. Okay, once it's done downloading, it's fine. We can get that, close that, and also go to your, what they call My Downloads here. You go to the Downloads folder, and once you're done with that, you can run this. sales run. You look for the folder where you want to extract that. I'll put them in, okay. I want this folder, the one we created. We say, okay, you extract all those drivers there. You click, then it's done. But extraction is okay. So now what you do, you go to your that folder, which is Ricoh. So what when you want to select, we're gonna install the software from there. So now what you do, we go to your what they call add printer. So when you want to add printer, you say add a new printer, and say add a network printer. You leave that USB. Let me see. Let me select this. Let me see. Collect that. Okay, still we can't see that Ricoh. Updates. I have a disk. So I'm gonna say I have a disk. And okay. Which disk you have? Browse here. We talked about the disk you're talking about. So when you browse here, you can go in all your information and try to see that disk, the one you're talking about. So I'm gonna look into that. It says system 32. I don't want that. I'm gonna go to C disk. Then you go here, you click here, you click onto that disk. This one is the setup. Then you say enter. Once you enter, say okay. So this is Ricoh one or whatever. Then you say next. When you say next, okay, now you are what? You are installing those drivers. Once the drivers are done, the printer is going to what to print. You say next, next, finish. So once we finish, you can see the printer is like this. So 50% sure that the printer is going to print. Then we go to Word, unless if it wants us to restart the printer. Once you go to Word, you can see it's here and say PP. We double click that, then we come here and we try to print out. We select that already selected. Then we see the printer. We say print out. It should print. You can see now, once I click there, the printer is going to print. You see, it's printing. Okay. It has printed already. So this is the printout we did, like with PP. Yeah, guys, thanks for watching. This is the way how to set up your Ricoh 171 SP machine on your laptop. So you saw how to use Windows 7 and also use the same strategy when you're using Windows XP. Because on Windows 10, already the drivers are there. You just plug and play. But if you be into this position, you do that. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next video.